The halacha about making on Shabbat your challah crunchy. You put your challah on top of the blech. Is that permitted to put on Shabbat the challah on your blech, on your hot plate? And by that, you're making it crunchy. It becomes much more delicious. We have two opinions about this. There are those that allow and those that forbid. We said that Chacham Avadia allows it, and you have others as well, Huchani, of Nisim Karedits, Zatzal as well. And there's a bunch of poskim that say it's asur. The Ben Ishchai says it's asur in Rav Pealim. The Or Letzion says it's asur. Kaf HaChaim says it's asur. Shmirat Shabbat Kilchata says it's asur. So we have a machloket. What is the machloket based on? We explained that the machloket is a double machloket. Do you say that you could do what is called makebe patish on food? Makebe patish is finalizing a food item. Just like by kelim, you have makebe patish. Do you have makebe patish in food? Im yesh makebe patish beochlin, that's a big machloket. The biur halacha in Shin Yud Chet Sif Daled brings down those that say it's asur. He brings the Meiri, the Prima Gadim, and then he himself cites that there's no makebe patish in ochlim. He brings poskim that hold like that as well. Yahu Rabba, he brings a list of poskim. That's how he holds halacha lemaase. Mimele, according to the Mishnah Berurah, there's no problem of makebe patish beochlin, and therefore you can change the shape of the challah from being a soft challah to a crunchy challah. It's not a problem. That's called makebe patish. But you don't have that in ochlim, so that's permitted. That's how the Mishnah Berurah holds in biur halacha. This is how Chacham Avadia brings halacha lemaase. Because of that, he says there's no problem. But many other poskim argue on that. As mentioned before, Ben Ishchai, for instance, holds that there is makebe patish beochlim, and therefore he's machmir. It's a question b'doraita. Second question that we mentioned was, do you say that when you take such a thing and you put it on the blech, it's considered that you're doing something different than the way it was baked? It was baked on the fire. Now you're putting it on the blech. The question is, do you say that there is, like, just like tzli, achar, afia, it should be either mutar or asur? There's two leshonot in the Shulchan Aruch. So is here, that is a different kind of doing something with the bread. It's not anymore baking it, it's putting it on the blech. That's not baking it. It's like tzli, roasting it in a way, or something else, but not baking anymore. Is that permitted? In the Shulchan Aruch, we found two lashonot about that. We know that en bishul achar bishul, but can you do something else? Like, for instance, can you do tzli achar bishul, bishul achar tzli, tzli achar afiyah? All those things come into a question. And in the Shulchan Aruch, we have two lashonot. They're written as yesh omrim ve yesh omrim. It's known that there's a big machloket. What do you do when you have yesh omrim ve yesh omrim? Chacham Avadia holds you go like yesh omrim batra, which is matir, ve yesh mishe matir. And therefore, he holds it's mutar. You're allowed to take something and do something else with it as long as it was baked once, cooked once, fried once, whatever it is, then you could do something else with it. You could, with something that was baked, you can roast, you can cook. It's baked. That's right. But that putting it on the blech is not considered afia. It's considered like tzli. It's considered like roasting. This is how the Or Letzion says. Just like, it doesn't say it's mamash roasting. It says just like tzli achar afia should be asur, so is here. Mimele the Or Letzion is machmir because of that. Because this shita is to be machmir like the Eshomrim kama, like most of the poskim, especially if it's a question, but the Oraita, Prima Gadim says that when you have Eshomrim, you go like the machmir. And there's a bunch of poskim that go like the Shomrim Kama, especially when it's Lechuma, especially if it's a question b'doraita, like our case. I spoke about this in length, about the Tkiot Shofar, whether you do like Rashi or like Tosfot, that's over there also, Yeshomrim v'Yeshomrim. Big discussion over there brought all the poskim that hold that you sometimes go like the Shomrim Kama, especially when it's Lechuma, especially when it's doraita. So over here, that's the question. Mimele Chacham Ovadia says it's permitted, there's no makebe patish beochlim, and also all the other aspects of tzliya, afia, if you hold it tzliya, but whatever it is, something else is happening over here. As the Taz brings down in Sif Katan Vav, Siman Shin Yudchet, that when you do something that changes the taste of it, is something that's not permitted. So over here, that's what the Kaf HaChaim says is the same, and therefore you're not allowed to make the bread or your challah such crunchy. It's not permitted. That's the Kaf HaChaim. So you have over here two opinions. What do you do when you have two opinions? So as always, those that follow Chacham over there, he's the rabbi, they should follow what he says, and they're allowed and permitted to put it on the blech. Those that wanna see largely what the poskim say, so we have a rule, we have a klal. Whenever you have a safek or machloket poskim, if it's machloket poskim bede rabbanan, you go lekula. If it's a machloket poskim bede oraita, you go lechumra. There's other conditions in that as well, but over here, that's what it seems it goes under that category of safek, or at least machloket aposkim. And those that don't follow on Chacham Ovadia, lichora, should be machmir on Shabbat, not to put it straight on the blech and to make it crunchy.